Hey guys, we're here at the Electric Violin Shop today, and we are talking about one of the most popular products that we sell, the Boss ME-80. People, of course, it's made for guitars, but people use it for electric violins, violas, cellos. Lots and lots of different people use this pedal. It's super, super handy. And one of the most common questions we get from people is, what's the best effects pedal for beginners? I don't like to say that there is any such thing as a best, because there's maybe a best for your situation and a best for my situation, maybe two different things. But I will say we recommend the ME-80 a lot. It's a really sweet pedal. It's a great price. It's got a ton of functionality in it. People sort of fall into two different camps in the effects world, where we go with separate stomp boxes, where you buy a separate reverb pedal and a separate flanger pedal and a separate wah pedal. Or people will go with multi-effects, where you get all that different functionality in one pedal. And we've got another video that talks about the pluses and minuses of those two camps. But the ME-80 really kind of takes some of the best features of each of those worlds and combines it into one pedal. One of the things I like about a multi-effects is you only need one power supply. You buy one pedal, so it's cheaper. You only have to bring one thing with you. You don't need patch cables to connect everything. Right? So it's pretty simple. But one of the things I like about separate stomp boxes is that if you've got a delay pedal and you really want to kind of get in there and tweak the feedback on that delay pedal, there's a knob to do that. The ME-80 has that knob. So it really sort of acts like it's like sort of six or eight different individual stomp boxes, but they're all combined into one unit. Now you know why we really like referring this pedal to people. It's really intuitive. I don't want you to be intimidated because, oh my God, there's a lot of buttons on there. It looks like I'm trying to pilot the space shuttle here. It really makes total sense the way it's laid out. If we look at this pedal, and you can see at the top half where all the knobs are, there's sort of a white box drawn around sections of these knobs. And let's look at the one that's right next to me here. This one here that says reverb, right? If we go down and look at, say, these black foot switches at the bottom, look at the third one over from the left and see in the highlighted section it says REV or reverb. If you push that button in, it's going to turn on that reverb section. If you look over to the left one from that reverb pedal, you'll see where it says EQ. Well, it turns on the EQ sections at right next to the reverb. So it sort of acts like a bunch of different stomp boxes. And if you look at the bottom row of the highlighted knobs, let's look at, say, the third one over where it says mod. The top knob, you turn that and that tells you which effect you're getting, whether it's a pitch shift or a vibrato or a chorus. It's set to flanger, I think, in this picture. And then the three knobs underneath it control the parameters of that flanger or that tremolo or that chorus. So the top one, you decide which stomp box it is. And then those three underneath, you can control the parameters of that stomp box. And then the foot switch underneath where it says mod is where you turn that pedal on and off, right? So that's pretty cool. And then you say the Boss ME-80 can do so many different things. And you go, well, what does that mean? So many different things. I'm new to the effects world. I don't know what that means. I'm going to play a number of examples for you in the next minute and a half or 2 minutes, where you can see there'll be a picture in the top of the video here that'll show you what the setting is that I'm using. And then you'll be able to hear what that sound is. So you can go, oh, holy cow, this thing really can make a lot of different sounds. So here we go. Thank you. Right, so you can see there is a ton of different sounds that you can make with this thing. And yeah, I mean, I think it's a great pedal for allowing people to explore a bunch of different sounds and learn about, hey, do I like this one? Do I like that one? Without spending a ton of money. These pedals are only about $300. It's made out of metal. It's not a cheap plastic pedal. It's going to break when you take it to a club with you and somebody falls on it. Yeah, that happens. Ask me how I know. So yeah, let's go through some of these different sections and we'll talk about them a little bit more in depth. So the preamp section, you can see on the left-hand side, you've got at the top says stack and then drive, lead, combo, crunch, tweed, clean. So those are all different types of preamps in that preamp section that'll give you mostly distortion sounds. So these are sort of more geared toward guitar players, but you can change the gain is what controls the amount of distortion that you get. And then you've got bass, mids, and treble. And then like each of these sections, you can control the level of that section sound so you can level your sounds out. If you want just a little bit of that distortion in there, well, you just turn up the level a little bit, right? The next section is the EQ slash effects 2. So you can do some EQ here. You see where it says bass, mids, and treble at the bottom. And let's see how that EQ on the left-hand side, see how it's outlined? Well, bass, mid, and treble are outlined there, right? So you can say, oh, okay, well, those are the ones that correspond to EQ. And then at the top, you see where it says rate and time, depth, or level, and those aren't outlined. Well, the other effects that are phaser, tremolo, boost, delay, chorus, those are not outlined. So you know that knob controls on the, say, on the chorus, they will control the rate of your chorus, okay? So these are multifunction knobs, and if you sort of learn a little bit about how the pedal is laid out, then they make total sense. This next one, reverb, this is a little tricky. It's got sort of those three areas, right? You can see right now it's about halfway up on the room reverb. If I keep turning that knob, it's going to go to max room reverb, and then just a little bit more is going to take it to minimum hall reverb. And then it goes all the way up to top of hall reverb, and then it'll go to the max of spring reverb. So that makes sense the way that knob controls three different parameters. This next one is a compressor or effects one. And you can see on the left-hand side, a defretter, really more of a guitar thing. There's sort of a slow gear. You heard the octave sound earlier. And then the T-wah down and the T-wah up, those are auto-wahs. And then there's a compressor in there. And you can see some of the different parameters underneath that correspond to the different effects that you're going to hear in that section. So you can pick one effect in that section, whether it's an octave or an auto wah. You can engage that with the button down below and then you control the parameters on it with the three knobs at the bottom. There's got an overdrive and distortion. That's OD and DS is overdrive and distortion. There's a bunch of different kinds of overdrives and fuzzes and distortions here. And you can control drive, controls how much of that overdrive sound, excuse me, drive controls how much of that sound there is. Tone will sort of how much brightness that sound has. And then level obviously turns the effect up and down. In this mod section, there's a bunch of different choices here. There's a vibrato, a chorus, a tremolo, a phaser, a flanger, a harmonist, which is an intelligent harmonist. You can tell it, look at this. This button on the left, you could tell it what key you're in, and that key will show up in the display on the ME-80. And then you can say, I wanted to be in the key of D, and I want you to add a major third above the note that I'm playing, and it can totally do that. Okay, so it can play double stops for you. Woohoo! And they'll always be in tune. How do you like that? This delay section, delay is essentially echo, so it's where you know, I would snap, but you hear it go snap, 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 snap. right? So there's a bunch of different kinds of delay here, and you can find them here. And then the bottom right, look where that says phrase loop. This actually does have a looper built into it. It's a fairly simple one button looper, but if you want to get into some very basic looping, the ME-80 can do that for you. Again, at the bottom, we've got the foot switches. Now you can see that amp, EQ, reverb, all those are in sort of that white highlight. You go, what are these banks and what are the other knobs on there? What are the numbers? So if you find a sound that you really like, you can save that sound as a preset. And then if you go into preset mode, then you can use these foot switches, the 1, 2, 3, 4, to say, I want to use preset 1, preset 2, preset 3. And it will recall those sounds that you have saved. So you can use it as a multi-effects pedal. You can make a bunch of sounds that you like and save them. And then you just use those sounds. Or you can use it in what they call manual or stomp box mode, where you're literally just tweaking the sound, the knobs that are on the board. So you basically, like I said, you sort of have a multi-effects or a bunch of stomp boxes all in one, which is really cool. And then the expression pedal itself, where it's that pedal, the sort of wah pedal or volume pedal on the right side, it functions as a volume pedal unless you tell it you want it to function as something else. It can be a wah pedal. It can have sort of a voice effect to it. There's +1, +2, and -1 octave. When you heard me do that sort of dive bomb sound, that was on the -1 octave. And then there's some other stuff on the right that you can get involved with, and a lot of stuff to experiment with on this pedal. Just so you know, all of these things are in a certain order in your signal chain. When you've got a regular pedal board with a bunch of stomp boxes, you put them in a certain order. In the ME-80, this is the order of the effects there. So you can see that it's got the pedal effects, which is like your wah, your volume pedal, and then you've got FX1, overdrive and distortion. The preamp section comes in, and then NS is a noise suppressor. So if you want like a noise gate, you can dial that in the menu. And then there's the foot volume pedal, the mods, the EQ plus FX2, delay, and then reverb, and then that's how it all comes out. So very, very cool pedal. We like this pedal a lot. And I think it's an outstanding pedal, not just for beginners, but for high-level pros. Christian Howes is a high-level professional jazz violinist, and he uses this pedal a lot. And in fact, we're having a discussion with him about this pedal, and you can find a link to that video right here. So, all that to say, make sure that you subscribe to our YouTube channel and Christian Howes' YouTube channel. You can check out these other videos here too. Thank you guys for hanging out, and we look forward to seeing you again soon.